Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about the release branch in Gitflow, how it works, what you do with it, and how you merge it into master and develop. So there is the Gitflow release branch right there. And this is sort of a prototypical little Gitflow example. Whenever you initialize Gitflow, you get your master branch and you get a develop branch that is branched directly off of it. Of course, we do development, and on this develop branch, well, we add some features and we do some commits until finally, boom, we end up having a project that is feature complete. When that happens, what we do is we create a release branch. That's what we're talking about right here. When we create the release branch, we don't add any other features to it. But, you know, some last minute testing might show some bugs, in which case we do bug fixes. By the way, anytime you do a branch off the release branch, a topic branch, and then merge it back into release, those topic branches are known as bug fix branches. But anyways, we do some last minute testing, and then finally, when we're done, this release branch gets merged into master and it gets tagged. And also, just to make sure that any fixes that happen to the release branch also get pushed back to develop, we do a merge back into develop as well. So that release branch, it branches off of develop, but it merges into both master and to develop. And when that's complete, well, we delete the release branch because we don't need it anymore. And so that's sort of how it works. Well, that's not sort of how it works. That's exactly how it works. But let's take a look at a little example. I'm going to initialize Gitflow right here. And as it starts to initialize, it asks me what I want for master. I'm just going to click enter to accept the default master, develop, feature, bug fix, release, hotfix, support. I'm not going to have any prefix to my tab. That looks like a good hooks directory. And all of a sudden, we now have Gitflow initialized. Now, you might be curious, what branches are available after it's been initialized? Now, you might assume bug fixes, release, hotfix, all these branches are created. After all, it asked us what we wanted to support, but look at this. Only two branches are actually created right at the beginning, master and developed. And as I mentioned earlier, master and developed, those are the only two that are created right off the bat with Gitflow. But you know, if you're doing development, typically what you do is you create some feature branches. So in order to add a feature branch, all you have to do is say Gitflow, hey, create a feature branch for me. Let's start that feature branch, give it a name. I'm not very creative, so I'm just going to call it feature branch. And all of a sudden that gets created. And if you now take a look at the different branches that are available, there you go. You see that feature branch. Now, by the way, something I forgot to do, I like to actually take a look at the different tags that are available at the beginning of the process. And you can see there's actually one tag there, 0.1.0, that's already been created. I think it's a holdover from my Gitflow history. But it's interesting to see what's there because we will improve on that a little bit later. Okay, so now we've taken a look, we see the branches we've got, the different tags that we've got as well. Well, we're going to work on that feature, commit, and then finally that feature branch is done. And what we do is we say, hey, let's finish that feature branch. And so Gitflow says, okay, well, we'll take care of that feature branch. We will merge that branch right back into develop. So that feature branch is down here. I don't have it on that particular diagram, but you can see it on some of the others on the server side. Okay, now if I do a git branch dash a and see what's floating around, you'll see that feature branch is gone. We are feature complete and everything's in develop. So what do you do once you are feature complete? Well, what you do is you get that Gitflow release branch started. So I'm going to paste in here, Gitflow release start. Well, we saw that we had a tag called 0.1.0. That's a holdover from when I did this tutorial before. So let's change it. Let's do 0.2.0. Let's increase that tag by a decimal increment. So we've started the release branch. Now let's take a look at all the different branches that are available right now, dash A. So you see, we do indeed have this release branch and we have been switched onto it. Now let's assume we've got a couple of changes to be made to that release branch. Those are called bug fixes. And so you might create a bug fix branch and then merge it back into the release branch. And once you're done, you then finish the release. And it was release 0.2.0 that we had before. So I'm going to now finish that release, git flow release finish. And all of a sudden, what do you think happens there? Well, that release branch is going to be deleted. Now, as it's deleted, it's actually going to ask me for a little bit of information on the merge. So I'm going to say, yeah, release done, and it's good. Actually, that's a really poor git commit message, but it'll do for this. And all of a sudden, we now get that new tag added. Now, if I do a git branch dash a, notice the release branch is gone. It's been deleted. Where is it? Well, it's been merged into master. And you know what? It's been merged into develop as well. So we were in this situation here before we did that git flow release finish call. When we did the finish, well, deleted that branch. But before deleting, it merged it into master and it merged that content into develop just in case there was a fix in here that made the release branch different from development. We want those fixes that would happen here to make sure they find their way into development too. But of course, it gets put into master. And now one last thing, git tag dash L for list. And you see, boom, we've got another tag in there, 020, because it was 020 that we released into the master and the develop branches. And there you go. That's how the git flow release branch works. And there you go. That's how easy it is to work with the release branch in Gitflow. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com? I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got lots of great tutorials on Git, GitHub, Gitflow, DevOps, enterprise software development, you name it. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can always follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on the YouTube.